So we're going to talk about how stress can actually make you fat, okay? Now, I've had some diabetics test their blood sugars when they go through stress, and it definitely increases the blood sugar. So let's talk about why. So the body's response to stress is it spikes cortisol. It will also elevate adrenaline. Now, cortisol, another name for it is glucocorticoid, okay? So it has something to do with glucose. It has the potential to significantly raise your blood sugars. So here you are, you're on the ketogenic diet, you're not eating any carbs, you're even fasting, and your blood glucose goes up because you're stressed. Interesting. Also, trauma will do it too. I remember when I was riding my bike and my chain locked up. I went over the handlebars on the cement, going 30 miles an hour. Next thing you know, I'm laying there in a state of shock. And you know, I was like craving sweets like crazy and incredibly thirsty because my blood sugar, you know, went up and then insulin kicked in and it went right down. I ended up with like low blood sugar. I was like, what's happening here? So cortisol will raise your blood sugars significantly. It will also release glucose from your liver, okay? So we have this stored sugar in the liver. It can dump the stored sugar when you're under stress. So it ends up in your bloodstream, right? So then insulin has to come in and take it and put it into storage. Also, it deaminates. What does that mean, deaminates? Well, there's a little word in there, aminate, which has to do with amino acids. It basically takes apart amino acids. It breaks down protein and it turns it into glucose. It's called gluconeogenesis, the creation of new glucose from something else. It could be from ketones, it could be from fat, it could be from protein. But with cortisol, it will tend to break down your proteins. This is why women, specifically after menopause, get atrophy. They start losing their muscle mass when they get older, and it just turns into fat, and then the blood glucose goes up, so it's not a good situation. Also, cortisol decreases insulin sensitivity, and this is what will lead to insulin resistance, which will then cause the body to make more insulin, to make more fat, to make a slower metabolism. It's a vicious cycle. Also, cortisol will drive the storage of fat to your midsection or to your viscera around the organs in the midsection and the liver. So this is why people that have a lot of stress end up with midsection weight, skinny legs, because the body is extracting and breaking down protein from the thigh muscle, the quadricep, and the gluteal muscles in your butt, and it turns that into sugar and then to convert it to fat around your midsection. So now you know the mechanism between stress and belly fat. If you have not seen my main video on stress, I put it right here. Check it out.